दीपांजलि मोइत्रा। संयुक्त राष्ट्र महासभा में अपनी स्पीच के दौरान पाकिस्तान प्रधानमंत्री इमरान खान ने कश्मीर से आर्टिकल 370 हटाने को लेकर कहा था कि जब कश्मीर से कर्फ्यू हटेगा तो वहां पुलवामा जैसा एक और हमला हो सकता है और भारत इसका इल्जाम हमारे ऊपर लगाएगा।
Kashmiris will be further radicalized. Mr. President, there will be another Pulwama. And guess what? India will blame us. They're already blaming us. They're saying this, all this is happening because of Pakistan. One of their defense ministers said there are 500 terrorists lined up on the border to go in. Why would Pakistan send 500 terrorists when there are 900,000 troops? What impact are they going to make?
अब अमेरिका को भी ऐसा लगने लगा है कि पाकिस्तान समर्थित आतंकवादी भारत पर हमला कर सकते हैं। अमेरिका ने कहा है कि अगर पाकिस्तान इन आतंकवादी ग्रुप को काबू में रखे तो ऐसे हमलों को रोका जा सकता है। इंडिया पैसिफिक सुरक्षा मामलों के असिस्टेंट डिफेंस सेक्रेटरी रैंडल शाइवर ने वॉशिंगटन में कहा कि कश्मीर पर फैसले के बाद कई देशों को डर है कि आतंकवादी समूह सीमा पार से हमलों को अंजाम दे सकते हैं। कश्मीर मुद्दे पर चीन द्वारा पाकिस्तान को समर्थन देने के बारे में पूछे गए एक सवाल में शाइवर ने कहा कि मुझे नहीं लगता कि चीन इस तरह का कोई संघर्ष चाहेगा या उसका समर्थन करेगा। मुझे लगता है कि कश्मीर मुद्दे पर पाकिस्तान को चीन का समर्थन बहुत हद तक कूटनीतिक एवं राजनीतिक समर्थन। गौरतलब है कि इन दिनों विदेश मंत्री एस जयशंकर अमेरिका के दौरे पर हैं। रैंडल शाइवर ने विदेश मंत्री एस जयशंकर के मौजूदा दौरे का जिक्र करते हुए कहा कि अमेरिका उनके साथ विचार विमर्श कर रहा है।
Now, I just briefly want to make the people understand, how can anyone do something like this? And for that, I have to explain to you what is RSS. RSS, Mr. Narendra Modi is a life member of RSS. RSS was an organization that was inspired by Adolf Hitler and Mussolini, came about in 1925. They believed in racial purity, racial superiority. They also believed they were an Aryan race, like the Nazi believed they were an Aryan race. All that I'm saying can be verified. This is the time of information revolution. You can Google all this, what I'm saying. But it is very important for me to explain this to you so you know what is happening in India. This RSS believed in the ethnic cleansing of Muslims from India. At one point, there was racial superiority of the Hindu race. Secondly, it was hatred for the Muslims and for the Christians, because they believed that this golden age of Hindu civilization was stopped because of Muslim rule centuries back and then the British rule of India. So it was racial superiority and hatred for Muslims and Christians. This is openly stated. You look at the founding fathers of RSS, Golwalkar and Savarskar. Just Google them and you'll find out. And this ideology of hate is what murdered the great Mahatma Gandhi in 1948. It was this ideology of hate that made Narendra Modi in 2002 do a pogrom against Muslims in Gujarat when he was the chief minister. He allowed 3 days for these RSS goons who were inspired by the Hitler brown shirts. They actually wear brown shirts. This RSS, the Congress Home Minister gave a statement that in RSS camps, terrorists are being trained. And these terrorists butchered 2,000 Muslims and 150,000 Muslims were made homeless. Narendra Modi could not travel to the US because of that. And I need to make you understand this background before I explain to you that what sort of a mindset would lay siege to 8 million people with 900,000 troops? Women, children, sick people, locked in as animals. In fact, of what I know of England, if 8 million animals were locked in, the RSPCA would have made a lot of noise about it. These are human beings. And Mr. President, what comes with racial superiority, these illusions of Aryan superior race, is arrogance. The two go together. And it's arrogance that makes people make mistakes and do stupid things, cruel things like what Narendra Modi has done. It's sheer arrogance. And it's arrogance that has blinded him from the fact that what is going to happen when the curfew is lifted? Has he thought about it? This hasn't been thought through. What is he going to do when he lifts the curfew? Does he think that people of Kashmir will quietly accept the status quo because India has changed the constitution and taken away the special status? They'll accept that? Mr. President, 100,000 Kashmiris have died in the past 30 years because they were denied the right given by the United Nations, the right for self-determination. 100,000 have died and 11,000 women have been raped. There are two human rights, United Nations human rights reports on this. The world hasn't done anything because India is a huge market, 1.2 billion people. Sadly, the material prevails over the human. But this has serious consequences. Again, I repeat, that's why I'm here. Look, what is going to happen when the curfew is lifted will be a bloodbath. The people will come out. There are 900,000 troops there. They haven't come to, as Narendra Modi says, he's done this to for prosperity of Kashmir. This is supposed to be for the development. These 900,000 troops, what are they going to do when they come out? There'll be a bloodbath. Has he thought it through what happens then? Mr. President, has anyone thought that what happens when there is a bloodbath? What do you think the impact will have on people of Kashmir? What do you think they will think the way they have been boxed in their houses, treated like worse than animals, no rights? Thousands of all the political leadership has been arrested, taken out of Kashmir. Even those Kashmiri leaders who were pro-India have been taken out. 13,000 boys have been picked up and taken to God knows which destinations. So what do they think? What will the people of Kashmir do when they lift the curfew? They will be out in the streets. And what will these soldiers do? They will shoot them. They've already used pellet guns, blinded young boys. In the last 6 years, the 5 years, the oppression that has gone on in Kashmir. And so, Kashmiris will be further radicalized. Mr. President, there will be another Pulwama. And guess what? India will blame us. They're already blaming us. They're saying all this is happening because of Pakistan. One of their defense ministers said, there are 500 terrorists lined up on the border to go in. Why would Pakistan send 500 terrorists when there are 900,000 troops? What impact are they going to make? What will they do? And why would